Hello everyone, this will be the review of game Villages, and the key was provided by developer. Now, this is one of the most interesting games that I've had on my, actually two playlists. I'm going to add this game to my other playlist as well, because the game allows to make money on Steam, which is awesome, which is absolutely awesome. And I'm also gonna make a review, which I'm doing right now. This is my playlist with reviews. I'm also adding it on my Polish playlist with games that allow making money on Steam. The game has extremely brilliant economy system. This is something that I was waiting for 2 years, as long as I'm on Steam market. This is something that always should have been on Steam, but it almost never was there. Similar things were, let's say, in Auction House in Diablo, but it was deleted. So, what is so awesome about the economy system? Basically, everything you get in game, every item you get in game, is also an item on Steam, which means that you can change all your digital goods into real money, or at least Steam money, one to one, at least right now. Now, the game is in very early alpha, very, very, very early alpha. It's going to be released in over a year from now. It's 2019 fall, so over a year, and a big patch is coming in 4 months, I hope at least, because this is a very big project and it can just as well fall down. It can be never finished and it can collapse. I cannot say it's going to happen. I can only hope it's going to happen. Because as for right now, the game only takes less than 400 megabytes. It wanted 20 gigabytes on Steam, but it only loaded 400 megabytes. This is some beta key. The full game is about to be $75 and has a lot of DLCs and tons of options. Right now, it has only two things. It has only one activity and the shop, but the shop already works. I'm gonna show you now the shop. So let's look at this. This is the shop in game, and each one of those items is also a Steam item. So, like this, I just acquired 5 items on Steam. They're going to be processed and appear in my Steam inventory, and then can be sold to another player. And it already works. The economy system already works. There are already people who want to buy those things. I already sold some items, even though the game is not released. It has super early alpha with one map and there is almost nobody playing it. So if this game grows in any way, if it's actually finished, released, more items are added, more mechanics are added, then it's gonna be extremely big and it's gonna allow you to make money while playing game, which is always, it was always my dream actually. Out of 13,000 games on Steam, only around 50 have items connected to Steam Market, and many of those are fake. I personally tested around 20 games which allow some sort of money making, some sort of item farming, but none of these games had this good system. The two systems that were pretty good were actually deleted from Steam. I'm talking about Mighty Quest for Epic Loot and Sinners of the Dark Age, or I think that's the name, because I already forgot, it was 2 years ago. Great games, actually, very good business models. They both died, they both were abandoned by developer. Now, this game is being done by one guy, and I personally talked to him. I can only wish him luck. I hope it's gonna be finished. I hope this game is gonna grow. And I'm gonna also show you now what can you do. So, aside from buying the items here, you can also do one activity. Basically, you have to take a car and delivery some package. It actually loads the package automatically between 2 points. So you start the game by just taking the car. I think it's somewhere there, or at least it was. Yes, it's there. So basically, you start somewhere there. I'm not gonna go there because it's too long. You start somewhere there, just where you spawn in the game, and then you take the car and go all the way this road, all the way to the point where you load the payload, and then you go back again all the way, and then you get 30,000. That's how you start. Then you can start buying things in the shop. Now you might think this is nothing. Well, before I show you the car, I'm gonna show you why it's awesome. And this is kind of like idle or clicker game. So of course you can do those runs with a car, which probably take like 15 to 20 minutes because it has really bad driving model. And then once you have 30,000, you can buy bonds. Now, as you have seen right now, I just got all that money and it happens every 10 minutes. So every bond you have gives you 5%, which in this case is 500 money, every 10 minutes. And if you know math, you will understand how fast it goes. So right now I got over 150,000, which means it's equal to 5 runs with a car. But I don't have to do 5 runs with a car, which would probably take an hour or more. I can only leave the game as is and just click every 10 minutes. Just take the stuff, take the money, buy more stuff to sell, and let process. And that just come back in 10 minutes. I come back in 10 minutes, boom, I have another 170. Of course, it took me over 20 hours to make it spin to buy enough bonds. I had to first do some runs with the car, then I was farming those and slowly progressing. You know, it needs 20 cycles to get even with one bond. So you get 500, 500, 500, 20 times. It takes 4 hours of real time. You have to grind it, but at some point you reach so much money that you can just buy probably everything, at least for now. Now, I cannot say where the game will go from here. I can only say that so far the economy system already works with only a few people even having the game. They're all probably people who got beta keys. The game is not released and it's not gonna be released for a year. There will be a patch in 4 months, hopefully. And Mr. Developer is promising a lot. He's promising crafting stations, building, producing items, getting resources, having skill points, all that stuff that we know from crafting, building, survival, production games. And if that, all of that is implemented, and if the system stays intact, this means that you could be making money by playing game. What is more, all those items you get now in the beta period will stay, at least they are supposed to stay. So even now I can collect stuff and then use it when the game releases, or I can sell all that stuff to people who want it. So let's say that you want to start, right? You want those bonds. You can say like, okay, I want 100 bonds because I don't want to go through the grind. I'm just too lazy. So I'm going to pay you, let's say, 1 cent per bond. So you invest $1, right? And from now on, you have those 100 bonds and you are making 50,000 money. So you can, every cycle, you can buy 5 of these, right? You can just buy it, buy it, buy it, buy it, buy it. 10 minutes passes, you get money again, 50,000, boom. You keep buying. So this is like a clicker game. Like, it's not really idle, it's slightly idle game, also clicker game. Of course, you can also run by car. If you say, okay, I don't have many bonds, it's slow, I'm just getting like 1,000 per cycle, you can just go with a car and use it, right? And make 30,000, go back and buy it. So for now, we have this environment, which is okay for a game like that. I would say this is okay. If you ever played any crafting survival building game, that's probably enough. It's badly optimized, but we know it's not the most important part here. The car is very loud, but it's supposed to have mute button. So you have the car and you go like, you can switch on and off, and you can change gears, you can go on reverse, and let's see how it works. Should be running, but it's not. Well, now it is. Okay, I should be pushing forward to go on reverse, but I'm pushing backwards. So you can use the car and deliver the package. I'm gonna switch it off now. So yes, you can start by either buying bonds. This is like shares of a company, basically. You can buy shares of a company. For instance, you can buy from me, which I would be very, very grateful if you do. Or you don't have to pay anything. You don't have to go into the market at all. You can just play the game and grind money, 30,000 at a time. Then you can go to the shop and start your own business. Now, of course, what's gonna happen? If I go here, the car is going to be spawned, but I want it to spawn. Is it still there? Yes, it's there. Basically, if you go to the phone booth, the car will spawn here. I'm going to do one more thing here, one more time, just check what's going on. Let's see. Okay, it processed. I can get more bonds. I probably have like over 300 right now. So I'm making like half of it. So 150 plus. Oh, I actually have a bit more, but whatever. Those are supposed to probably boost you while you will be crafting or something. I don't know really what will be in the game. If anything will be in the game, there might be crafting, there might be mining, there might be different jobs and base building and whatnot. But at this point, all we have is this car, which allows us to start business, and we have a trading system directly combined with Steam. Now I wanted to say one more thing. If you are a developer, or if you are a worker or somebody important on Steam, we want this. We want this to work. We want eventually to make money by playing games, not just 50 games that are half of them are fake and others have ridiculously bad drop rate, which is like, I don't know, CSGO has 10 hours to guarantee a drop, which is usually 1 cent. This here is way better. This here is awesome, guys. Imagine what would happen if you would be able to exchange everything in a game into real money, because this is almost real money. You can actually even, you know, sell some stuff on external sites from Steam, and then, you know, even take out money if you want to, if you really want to. But normally you just buy games and DLCs and stuff and trading cards and everything, right? What would happen if you could just play any game, let's say modded Skyrim or Fallout or just any game whatsoever, and if every game you play just had trading items? Right now you might be against it. You can be like, this is bad, this is evil, whatever. Now you can choose not to take part in it, right? You can never touch market, you can never sell anything, you can just not care at all. Maybe you would be even able to switch it on and off in a game, right? Like go to servers that use those items and go to servers that don't use those items, or just play single player without it, right? But imagine what would happen if you would actually get items in every single game you play. Now, just think about your games. Think about any games you like, any games you play, and think what would happen if those games had working economy tied to Steam Market and to the game world, whatever game it is, it doesn't matter. It could be Guild Wars, like where I'm talking about MMO. It could be visual skins in any game, let's say Darkest Dungeon or Dark Souls. It could be, I don't know, what else I played. I played Grimdawn, right? Again, what would happen if you could just sell charms to players who are too lazy to grind them, right? Nobody has to buy it. Nobody has to sell it. Nobody's telling you that you have to take part in it. But just opening any game to Steam Market, to free economy, can benefit everyone. Steam gets money from every transaction. Developer gets money from every transaction. Trader who sells gets money from every transaction, and the guy who buys probably cheap, because people will compete and downgrade prices. Of course, this is a problem, because, you know, you want to keep prices high, at the same time you want to be able to give people what they want, and so on. You don't have to buy, you don't have to sell, you don't have to grind, you don't have to take part in it, but you can. And for a lot of people in the world are poor. A lot of people on Steam do not have many games. A lot of people on Steam cannot afford games, especially new titles. Now, if you open free economy and allow it in more games, especially not bad games, not games like that, those that exist now tied to Steam Market, I personally think only Don't Starve Together and Killing Floor 2 are playable. The rest is just either PvP or some complete junk that is 2D and slightly competitive PvP, extremely bad, or it's just basically super bad game that just happens to drop items and crazy people buy them. What if these systems this economy would actually be added to games that are playable, right? What if it was added to The Forest? What if it was added to, I don't know, Binding of Isaac? Any game, just any game at all. As I say before, you don't have to do it. You don't have to take part in it. You can just say, okay, whatever, I'm not going to waste my time on it, or it's pay to win, or whatever, right? Or get a job. Yeah, I get it. But some people have more time than they have money, than they have opportunities. They might already have a job, or they might be too young to have a job, or they might just like playing games. Now, there is no harm in making money while you play and while you enjoy yourself. Of course, doing this, right, isn't really gameplay. And it isn't really fun. It's just grinding, right? Doing this over and over again can basically fry your brain and make you crazy. However, if there is actual gameplay behind it, I'm not talking about just, you know, using a bad driving model in a car and going back and forth, which you have to do at least once. But people play tons of games, and if there are any mechanics added to this, if there is actually working well done model with cars where you deliver goods, like in all those simulators with like trucks, and you know, people play those games for free, they don't make any money. What if they could? People play builder games, you know. What if you were paid for, I don't know, building a house for someone and modeling it, like in Sims or like in any base building game, like in Fallout, you know? What if you could buy a real cottage that would actually give you something, for instance, boost your stats so that you can work better, and then you can go to mine and, you know, mine resources, like in any mining or resources management game, any building, any survival, but then you could sell it for real money. The concept is absolutely brilliant and genius. I have no idea if this game is going to get any further than this, but even now you can make money on it. You can start the business and make money at least to some extent, at least on some very low level. Probably if it releases, if more keys are given to people, if people will actually know that the game exists. So far, I haven't seen any video on YouTube. So my video can be the first. I have no idea. I hope there are more. If you know any other video, then just tell me. I'm gonna watch it. Also, the game had another map with another system, but I wasn't there, so I couldn't find any footage or any information how it worked. No idea what was there. Apparently there is this area and another area, something with war, but I don't know what's going on there. And here, at this point, when I'm making this video, you have just this. You have just a shop directly tied to Steam Market, and you have this one activity with a car. But if this game grows in any way, shape, or form, and even if it just continues like this, it can be a tool to make money. But if it grows, if it's upgraded, it's gonna be awesome. And I don't want it to die, I don't want it to disappear. I even talked to developer personally, there might be even more games. For instance, games like, let's say, Skyrim and Planet Nomads, right? What if all that would be a different environment? If you could make a village, medieval village, and do all the crafting, building, and farming there, and build an economy there. Or if you could do it on another planet, just like No Man's Sky or Planet Nomads. You know, build spaceships, craft stuff, parts for ships, mine resources, maybe terraform. God knows what can be done there. All with this economy, which already works and can work better. So if this game is finished, if more games start using this model, if the economy model in general is added to any game, this is gonna benefit everyone. You can choose not to do it, but if you can, it can make you money, maybe even be enjoyable as such, who knows, or it can allow you to have money on other games. So for me, who is a big gamer, big fan of games, but also a poor guy who cannot just, you know, spend money, put money into Steam and spend hundreds of dollars on stuff that I just, you know, am hyped for, or I just have a whim to have, I can't afford that, and most people in the world can't afford that. But if they could work for it in a digital world, that would be like every gamer's dream. Eventually, you would be able to say that you are actually making money here. Maybe even make a living out of it. You don't know that, you know? I heard about a game called Second Life. I don't know if people actually were able to make a living by investing and producing there. Some people also make assets for games, but this is a direct money-making system that exists in a game world and directly translates to real world. If this would go out of Steam, that would mean that people would be able to work being in a digital environment and just put money into bank accounts. This isn't really yet possible directly. I know there are ways to take money out of Steam and put it, let's say, on PayPal and then transfer to bank account. This is very convoluted and very hard to do, and you would need to make extreme amount of money on Steam, which right now most people cannot. Most people are not even aware how market works or that market exists. But there are extreme opportunities here, and I'm not talking just about, you know, games like CSGO, which have a lot of traffic, but there are really bad games. I'm talking what would happen if people would actually be able to get back some money for all the time they put into games, at least some games, because of course you play some games just for fun, and you play other games, I don't know, because they're competitive, and you play other games, or rather pretend to play them, just because they have loot boxes. But what if this was naturally connected? I would absolutely enjoy it. I would gladly sell tons of stuff from tons of games to people who would like to pay. I don't know about you. Write down what you think. I think this is a great start. This is a great opportunity. If you can get the key for the game, then do it. You can get it on Woovit webpage, and you can also ask for beta key in a specific webpage. Also check all the information on forum, the developer blog, the Steam page for the game, everything, because I might have missed something. I'm really hyped for this game. If this project dies, I will be, you know, heartbroken. But if it works, it's gonna be seriously best thing since sliced bread. Probably one of the best systems right now existing on Steam when it comes to economy. And maybe even in future, actually a playable game. So that will be it from me. I hope I explained everything here. If you have any questions, then write down in the comments what you think, how are you doing in the game, what would you add to it. The Mr. Developer is very responsive. I talked to him personally, so you can also leave any comments and suggestions on the discussion page of the game. I think that will be it. Just if you need anything more, or if the game is changed, updated, upgraded, any other map will show up, I can also review it and show it how it's progressing. I'm gonna definitely observe the game. So I guess that's it. This is like a fresh thing. I just do it for 2 days. So that's what I know for now. I best personally read everything information I could. Sadly, most of it is in the future, so this is again very fresh beta alpha, early alpha of beta alpha, whatever you call it. It's just barely started to exist, and it's gonna be upgraded, hopefully. So if the project doesn't die, might be awesome. If it dies, don't give up, keep making it. I'm talking to Mr. Developer, or just try to push it to another studio who can do it. And everybody else who's listening, every developer, everybody who has already games with Steam market items, everybody who plans to do it, people on Steam, people who trade, people who buy, people who, I don't know, grind or don't grind or maybe hate the idea. Guys, think about it. Because seriously, changing having fun into having fun plus making money is the best thing ever. And, you know, if it doesn't work, market will regulate it. If it's not going to be worth it, people will just abandon it. But I would like everybody to have the opportunity, right? If you have something great in a game, you should be allowed to sell it. In worst case, nobody will buy it, right? If, in best case, you will sell it for a lot of money. Someone will be happy that he has the item. You will be happy you have the money. You'll be able to buy a game, support developers, support Steam, support, I don't know, support yourself? Yeah, sort of, because you will be playing the game. And, well, everybody wins, seriously. If the prices are bad, if the economy collapses or anything bad happens, you can just not take part in it. Nobody is forcing you. So there are only benefits to it. I cannot understand why there's only like 50 games on Steam connected to the whole system, why nobody else is copying it, why people have weird economy systems outside of Steam, like let's say Fortnite or what else is outside Steam. Mass Effect 3, it wasn't on Steam with all the black items. I would gladly sell all my black items to people. So just put this stuff on Steam. Let people regulate the prices, the demand and supply between themselves. Just open it, allow them, and you will see. This is more a social experiment. This game is actually a little bit like this Peter Molyneux cube, where people flocked to this game, even though it wasn't even a game, and they tried to you know, break the box to get the reward, even buying money for the tools to do it. Here you don't even have to spend any money. If you get the key, you can just start making money. And if you want, you can speed up the whole process by investing like you would in real company. You can invest on Steam and buy some items and get a kickstart, or you can just do it from scratch for free. You just need the key for the game. So I think that will be it. I'm gonna finish this. I know it's a long video, but I wanted to tell you everything I think about this. I give this game absolutely full support and a shout out on my channel. Probably also gonna make another video, and I would like to hear from you what you think. And I wanted to thank Mr. Developer that he came up with this idea and put it on Steam. This really made my day. So big plus, big props for that. Guys, the game right now is 2 out of 10. The idea is 20 out of 10. The idea is completely brilliant. So I just wanted to develop into a fully existing game that would be playable and fun, but keep the whole system and items intact. Then it would be real dream of every trader, farmer and gamer on Steam. That would be it from me. I'm finishing the review. I will see you guys in the next one. See you around, and good money making.